Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, let's take a look at the Microsoft Fabric admin portal, what's available for you inside of there, and why you may see one thing versus another. Before we get into that, if it's your first time visiting Guy in a Cube, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, the Microsoft Fabric admin portal. Back in the day when this was just Power BI, it was the Power BI admin portal, but now it's Microsoft Fabric. There are things that you should know about it in terms of like, how do you get access to it? Why you would see something versus not seeing it. I want to go through all of those things. So, you know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Enough all this talking. Let's head over to my machine. All right. Inside of the Microsoft Fabric portal, you will see the gear icon. And within the gear icon, down below under Governance and Insights, you'll see Admin Portal listed there. One thing to call right off the bat is that every user is going to see that link to the admin portal. Like, even if they're not an admin. Let me show you. So let's get over to Jane Doe's login. And so Jane Doe, she's just a regular user. She's not an admin. Think of her as just a consumer of reports, and that's it. So if we click on the gear, we go to admin portal. What does Jane see? Jane sees capacity settings, refresh summary, and health and support. So everyone's gonna see this capacity settings, but you'll notice there's no capacities that Jane can see. Even if I go to embedded, trial, or fabric capacity, there's just nothing there because they're only gonna see what they have access to. But this is a way for capacity administrators to actually manage capacities without being a full-on what we call a tenant admin or someone that's a full administrator over Microsoft Fabric. So capacity administrators only have access to those specific capacities. And so that's why everyone sees the admin portal. Can be a little confusing, but that's why it's there. All right, so let's go back over to my user, which is a full tenant admin and a full Microsoft Fabric administrator. So let's go to the admin portal. And let's see here, the first thing you're gonna land on is this tenant settings. This is probably the most important thing because this controls what's enabled for your organization. And so you definitely wanna go through these things and validate from a governance perspective, what do you want enabled? What do you not want enabled? One of the nice things here is that you can actually see like what's been new and updated. So it's a good way to just get a quick look of, okay, what's new in here that I should go pay attention to? Because there is a lot of stuff in here that you should go through. And one thing to realize about a lot of these settings, let's look at Data Activator, right? So it's enabled, but I can actually go in and enable it for the entire organization, or I can specify specific security groups and or accept specific security groups. And so everyone except these groups can leverage this. So this is a good way that you can define certain capabilities for certain security groups and not just everyone, blanket everyone within the organization. Another option you will see here for some items is this capacity admins can enable or disable. So that means you can actually delegate this down to a given capacity. So you may have it turned off at the tenant setting, but then at the capacity level, you can enable it or disable it and then segment that just this capacity has this capability, which is another great way to limit exposure on certain items. So for example, I'm going to go down to database mirroring. This is disabled. And so I'm going to come in and say, yep, I'm just going to enable it because I want to be able to leverage database mirroring inside of Microsoft Fabric. Another area that's interesting from a Microsoft Fabric perspective is this concept of domains. If we think about the data mesh concept, if you're familiar with that, there's this idea of domains where you can group like-minded things. And so domains with inside of the admin portals, we can actually create these. So like I've created one for finance. This can have a subdomain as well. And then I can assign workspaces with inside of this given domain. So these workspaces are tied to finance. And so then when I go to something like one like Data Hub, I can come in and I can then filter it down to just that domain and I can see what it is that's relevant here. So think of this as a way to limit the noise that you may see as your organization uses Microsoft Fabric more. There's gonna be a lot of stuff out there. And so this is a quick way to get down to what do I care about? What am I leveraging? So definitely take time to create domains. One thing to realize at the recording of this video is that domains do not apply security context. That is something that's on the overall roadmap for Microsoft Fabric. So be on the lookout for that. Workloads is a new item that's available for Microsoft Fabric. So this is the idea where you can have third-party workloads and update those with inside of your organization. So this is where you would go do that. Check out the docs if you want to learn more. We looked at capacity settings from a non-admin, but now let's look at capacity settings from an admin. And so you've got these ideas of leveraging Power BI Premium, Power BI Embedded, which is created with inside of Microsoft Azure. You've got trial capacities and then your Fabric capacities themselves. So again, these are created integrated with inside of Microsoft Azure itself. And so here you can go in and manage these items and define who are the capacity admins. As a full tenant admin, I can see all of it. And then if you were a specific capacity admin, you'd only see the capacities you had access to. Refresh summary is also something that's available for you. These items are also available from the monitoring hub, which is right here. Embed codes are something related to publish to web. We've got videos out there for publish to web, but there's a tenant setting to enable or disable publish to web. As of the recording of this video, it's disabled by default. A while ago, it was enabled by default, and then that changed. And so the embed codes is where you can manage where items have actually been leveraged from publish to web. So you can revoke those codes as an admin. So this is definitely something to monitor and look at. Organizational visuals. So this is great if you want to leverage custom visuals with inside of your organization, but only specific custom visuals. Basically, from your tenant settings, you could say, I want to disable custom visuals, or I only want to enable custom visuals that are certified. However, items in this organizational visuals will override whatever those tenant settings are. So basically, you're whitelisting these custom visuals regardless of what the tenant settings are. And then you can optionally include them in the visualization pane inside a Power BI desktop if they're signed in. Got various Azure connections. So if you want to do DAX logging for a semantic model for Power BI, you'd want to configure an Azure Log Analytics account, or if you wanted storage accounts to be listed as well, this is where you can go set that up. As an admin, you can see all workspaces in your organization. So they may not be in your workspace list because you're not specifically included in those, but you could potentially go and inject yourself as an admin of a workspace so that you could get access to that. You know, say someone leaves the organization and you need to recover something, you can actually add a user into that workspace if needed. So that's a great admin function. Custom branding is cool. You can set up different things for the banner, colors, maybe an organizational image, things of that nature. Protection metrics. So this is all about purview integration. And if you're leveraging data protection labels with inside of your organization, you can also check out the Purview Hub as well. Help and support is also a nice area if you want to go and create a support request. All right, so that's a whirlwind of the admin portal, but who can get access to this? What are the settings I need to make sure someone can actually access or understand who gets access? So for that, we need to take a step back and look at how users are maintained with inside of your tenant. This can be done in one of two ways. One, your tenant is effectively what's also leveraged for Microsoft 365. And so you can go to the Microsoft 365 portal to manage users, groups, things of that nature. But the underlying tenant is also part of Entra ID. And so you could potentially manage it through the Azure portal as well. In this case, I'm going to go look at the Microsoft 365 admin portal and we'll take a look there. Let's go over with inside of the Microsoft 365 admin portal. If I look at active users, first off, let's look at just a generic Fabric user. And one thing you'll see down here is roles, and you'll see no administrator access has been granted. So if I hit manage roles, two things will allow access to the admin portal with inside of Microsoft Fabric. One, I have to go and select admin. Global administrator, it means that they are the main admin for your tenant as a whole. So that's even beyond Microsoft Fabric. That includes Microsoft 365. It includes a lot of stuff. So that is like the Uber admin role. And typically within organizations, you're going to limit how many people have global admin access because that has massive effects on your organization. So that is not how I recommend you give someone access to this. So the other thing you want to see is go down to show all by category. And if we scroll down, you'll see this Fabric administrator. Then what that means is they are an admin with inside of Microsoft Fabric specifically. So this gives them access to the admin portal with inside of Microsoft Fabric and can perform those admin capabilities. And while we're talking about admin access, one other thing I want to highlight to you, if you're either in that Fabric administrator role or you're a global admin, something you can do with inside of Microsoft Fabric, this relates to gateways. So let's go take a look. And so while it's not directly in the admin portal, if I come down to manage connections and gateways, the gateways and connections we'll see here are what's relevant to you as a user, right? So these are things that I can see that I have specific access to under my Saxton account, right? All these connections are mine or they've been shared with me. And then these are all the gateways that are mine and or I've been added to. So one thing you can do here is you'll see this tenant administration switch if you're either in that Fabric administrator role or a global admin. So if I hit on, now I can see more gateways, right? So I can see what Patrick's doing and then I can go add myself in as an admin on some of those. So again, this is a way or mechanism that you as an administrator of Microsoft Fabric can manage these things, right? And recover things or understand how things are working or get access to something. So I just wanted to point that out as another capability that you can get as part of those roles. All right, are you an admin of your tenant? Let me know in the comments below how you're leveraging these things. I'd love to know, or is there something maybe I didn't talk about that you think is amazing? and want to share that with everyone else, drop it in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.